A political analyst cautions the allies of Vice President Sara Duterte against branding her as the new leader of the opposition. Ronald Llamas says the vice president cannot even offer an alternative platform to counter the stand of the Marcos administration on various issues. Last week, the vice president quit the Marcos cabinet.
Just because you change hats or you change clothes doesn't define you as the opposition. Usually, pag sinabing opposition, meron ka namang ideology. Kung wala kang ideology, at least meron kang political platform, meron kang principles, meron kang vision na gumagabay sa pagiging political alternative mo. Si Vice President Sara, ang pinakamatindi niyang statement ay no comment.
Llamas adds at this point the Duterte clan is facing more threats to their political capital compared to the Marcos family.
Ang nakikita natin nitong nakaraang mga buwan ay yung pag-hemorrhage, yung pag-liit ng political base ng mga Duterte. Halos naubos na yung miyembro ng PDP Laban ng mga local officials. Hindi na rin invincible si Sara, nakakaramdam na rin siya ng kanyang political mortality. At makikita natin yan in the next survey before and after the midterms. No? Kaya yung pagiging high ni Sara sa preferential option for the presidency may no longer hold water in the next few months or years.
The Aquino family and their supporters are marking the third death anniversary of former President Noynoy Aquino at the Manila Memorial Park. Our very own Willard Cheng is there and he joins us now with that story. Willard, over to you.
Hi, Casey. Aquino family and friends gathered at Manila Memorial Park to remember former President Benigno Aquino III on his third death anniversary. Father Jet Villarin celebrated the mass in honor of Pinoy and remembered in his homily how the former president dedicated his life to serve especially the marginalized. Speaking on behalf of the Aquino family, Pinoy's nephew, Kiko Aquino D., recalled how his uncle lived by the principle right is might, as he fought for the rights of the country in the West Philippine Sea that led to the 2016 arbitral ruling, which has become vital in asserting the Philippines' rights, and which also meant respect for the Constitution, peace in the Bangsamoro, and his fight against corruption and good governance. Aquino D. said, this, in a sense, applies as well to the struggle for justice of former Senator Laila De Lima. Aquino D. urged those present to continue finding ways to serve the Filipino people. In fact, among those who were present in today's commemoration was former Senator Laila De Lima, who joined the commemoration for the first time since her liberty. She described Aquino as a good man and a good leader who believed and did not lose faith in her. In fact, ahead of De Lima's hearing in Muntinlupa RTC, one of the prayers of the faithful said in today's mass was for De Lima to obtain justice and fairness after what was described as years of oppression. Let's listen to former Senator Laila De Lima.
Wala po si Pinoy. Nasa loob po ako. Nakakulong po ako. And I was so shocked nung nalaman ko, pinadala na ko ng note ng aking staff na namatay na si Pinoy. Dahil hindi ko alam, may sakit pala siya. Kasi nung bibisita siya sa akin, hindi naman halata na may sakit siya. So, nung nakaraang anniversaries, this is now the third anniversary, hindi ko talaga... Ang sakit na naman sa kalooban ko na hindi man lang ako makapunta dito. And now that I'm free, and so nandito ako, so tuwang-tuwa ako dahil ako si Pinoy. But I miss him so much. He's such a good man, he's such a good leader, na ang dami kong natutunan sa kanya.
Also, those scenes in today's commemoration were former Senators Franklin Drilon and Bam Aquino, and members of the Aquino cabinet. Back to you, Casey.
Thanks a lot. Willard Cheng there joining us on the line. Motorists will have to brace for another big increase in petroleum products this week. Diesel prices will see the biggest jump of a peso and 75 centavos per liter. Gasoline will increase by 1 peso and 40 centavos. Kerosene all set for a more than 1 peso hike. The Energy Department attributes the second straight oil price hike to the Middle East conflict and the rising demand for petroleum products.